Galaxy Curaçao is situated at the island of Curaçao. It tells the story of three generations of black people, poor people, who try to escape from their poverty. The oldest man, the oldest generation, is Roy. He's a taxi driver. He's a macho, a real macho. His son, Max. Max is 12 years old when the novel starts. He don't want to become a taxi driver. He wants to become a teacher. And the youngest boy, Sonny, he doesn't know what he wants. But all of them want to escape from poverty. But it's also the history of the island. The novel takes 50 years, from 1961 until over 2000. And it was a former Dutch colony. And in 1969, it was the most important date, 3rd of May 1969, there was a big revolution in the town between the black and the white people. And at that moment, all of the island changed. For the Dutch people, who were the colonists, it wasn't a paradise anymore, so they go away. And the black people, they wanted power, but they couldn't handle with power. And that's what the story is about, between black people black people who want a new life, a great life, but when they get the chance, what will they do with it? Will they become taxi driver or teacher or nothing at all? Can we escape from our fate? Can we, if we have dreams, can we reach for these dreams? Or are there certain things why you can't escape? And especially on a small island like Curaçao, with a lot of criminality, with a lot of drugs, with a lot of racism between black and white people, is it possible, if you're poor, if you're black, to escape from your fate? And they are trying, and they are doing their best. When you finish the book, and I won't tell you the end, but it ends with an article. It ends with something has happened at the end of the novel. And that article, I had that article since 10, 20 years. And when I found that article later, I read it, hey, that's the story. What has happened with that man, and it's Max? Why is he in the plane to Holland? The book starts when he's in the plane to Holland. Why is he there? What is he doing? And I wanted to tell the story of only Max, but writing and writing, I needed these three generations to tell the story, what will happen to Max at the end of the novel. And I needed the history of this island to tell this. And my wife was born at Curaçao in 1960. And I was there the first time in the year 2000. And for me, it was completely new. I never been in the tropics. I never been farther than France or Germany or Belgium. So for me, it was when I was there, I was looking, oh, the paradise, the beach. But also I felt there was something wrong between the black and the white people. When I was in a shop, black people, they were always the servants, but they doesn't want to be servant. And there was something, and I didn't get it, what it was. I never in my life, at that moment, I was confronted with black and white people and with racism between black and white people. And in a former colony, never been in a former Dutch colony. And that was intriguing. And the second time, 2005, I was there and I wanted to see more of the island. And then in 2009, I wanted to write a novel. And I went back and I met an old taxi driver. I wanted to meet an old taxi driver because the story is fiction, but it could have happened. All could have been reality. And I met an old taxi driver, 99 years old, black, in an old man's home. I met also the only black brother, who tries to give the black people, the poor black people, a better life, but he fails also. So I talked to all these people, and so that's why my novel, when you're reading it, and also in Curaçao, also in Holland, also in Belgium, they are thinking, oh, this has really happened. And the sad thing is the end, I'm writing about how the book ends, it really happened.